Hey everyone, I'm Tom from WPWithTom.com, and today I'm going to teach you how to clone a WordPress website to another domain name. Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to clone a WordPress website to another domain name. And this is actually going to be a real simple process that we're going to do. I'm going to clone this site right here. It's called blogsite.mypracticeproducts.com. I'm going to clone that over to blogclone.wpwithtom.com, which is currently showing this, just this basic install page. And I want to show this whole website here with all that it has on it, just as an example. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to go into the dashboard of each of the sites. So I'll log in here and I'll go in the dashboard within the current blog that we have set up, and I'll go into the plugin section and I'll click add new. And I can do that in here as well if I would like to. I can go into plugins and click add new in here as well. And the plugin we're going to have to add is called WP Clone. And if we search for that, it will come up with this one right here, WP Clone by WP Academy. And you'll want to click to install it. I've actually already installed it on this one. And here I will search for it again within the other one. And this site is the one that's currently blank right here with nothing on it. And I'll click install now. And after it's installed, I'll click activate plugin right here. And you'll have to do that for both of them, both websites. Now once it's ready like that, since this site right here, this blog site.mypracticeproducts.com, is the one I want to move it from, I'm going to go to that one first. And within the sidebar here, you'll see if we scroll down a little bit that there's WP Clone right here in the sidebar. You'll want to click on that. And now what you want to do is you can click Create Backup. And now it comes with a message that says Backup Successful. And it says here's your backup file. And you'll want to just click Copy URL. And it says Copy to Clipboard. If not, you can just highlight it all and then copy it as well. But once we do that, we'll go back into this page here on the other website that's currently blank. And what we'll do is we'll go where it says WP Clone here on the left side and we'll click that one. Now I just want to show you what it looks like right now. It's just simply this website right here, just completely blank, nothing going on. And this is what it looks like when we refresh it after the WordPress install was done. So this is how it looks now, and we want it to look like this. What we'll do is we'll go in here and we'll click Restore from URL, and now we'll simply just paste in that code that we copied from over here, paste that code in to where it says Restore from URL, and then click I agree. And now we'll click Restore from URL. It says it takes a few minutes, proceed, restore now. I'll click OK. And now it says restore successful. Now if we want to, we can click to refresh this page here. And now we'll see that this page has had our website cloned over to it, to this domain name. It's completely cloned and it comes with everything. And I've never had an issue with doing this. It's always a quick way to clone one website to a new domain name. This is something that I highly recommend you do if you work with similar templates a lot, or customers want a certain template if you're running an agency, a design agency, and you can simply copy it over and save yourself so much time that you would have to spend building out the site and then edit it from there. Make sure you change the content, obviously, and change things like that so it doesn't affect the SEO for the website. Something you can also do is if you wanted to go back into this area, you can go down here within this page of the settings reading area, and you can click discourage search engines from indexing this site. That's something you might want to do so it's less likely to affect the new domain name and show up as duplicate content while you are changing that. And you'll just want to save those changes right here for those to go into effect. So that's one way that you can prevent duplicate content from showing up when you do clone a website like this. But I would definitely change the content on the new site, or maybe delete the old site completely if you have no intentions of using the old site anymore. So I hope this was helpful, And I hope this really helped you learn how to clone a WordPress website to a new domain name. Thanks for watching, everyone.